NASA is still on a big Moon 2024 push, and they want to get astronauts on the surface of the moon. They've awarded some new contracts, so let's talk about what that means coming up. Hey guys, Tori here from Overlook Horizon. If you're new to the channel, we fly high-altitude weather balloon flights to the edge of space and back, and along the way we talk about space, science, and technology. So, if that's something you're interested in, consider subscribing. On April 30th, 2020, NASA announced three big contracts for their upcoming Moon 2024 lunar missions. It should be no secret that NASA has a target date of 2024 for when they want to land astronauts on the surface of the moon again. And not only is 2024 still on the table for NASA, but it is the only option that they're pushing for. It is for now. The intent is to land astronauts again on the surface of the moon in 2024 and set up sustainable habitats there by 2028. The three most recent contracts are pretty noteworthy because this is the lunar lander portion for the vehicle that will take astronauts down to the surface of the moon. Now, these contracts provide initial development funding. They haven't actually selected a vehicle that will take astronauts to the surface yet, but this is still pretty good news for these three award winners. Now, this set of contracts will provide development work over the next 10 months and awards just under $1 billion worth of funding for that development. Those three contracts are going to go to Blue Origin, Dynetics, and SpaceX. All three of these companies will be launching their lunar lander separately from crew, and the crew will meet up with the lunar lander in lunar orbit. Now, Blue Origin is going to get the lion's share of the contracts, with $579 million going to them alongside their partner companies as part of the national team. The national team is a partnership of companies set up by Blue Origin, which also includes Lockheed Martin, Northrop Grumman, and Draper. Now, as part of that contract, Blue Origin will be the prime contractor. They'll be responsible for program management, safety, engineering, all that kind of stuff, and the other companies will follow their lead. Blue Origin will also be developing the descent element for the lunar lander. As part of their proposal, Lockheed Martin will develop a reusable ascent element and lead crewed flight operations. Northrop Grumman will develop the transfer element, and Draper will lead descent guidance and provide flight avionics. Dynetics is the second company to be awarded a contract, and they are getting $253 million. They're developing their lunar lander alongside a partnership with the Sierra Nevada company. They also have a bit of a unique approach to this because their Alpaca lander has a pair of drop tanks that are launched separately, which allows the main lander to be reused. These tanks are depleted and then jettisoned during descent. That Alpaca lander is expected to launch on a United Launch Alliance Vulcan rocket, which is their up-and-coming new rocket that they're developing. And lastly, what came as a surprise to many people in the aerospace industry is SpaceX. SpaceX was awarded $135 million to further develop their Starship platform. This is specifically intended to be a lunar-optimized Starship, which means that it won't have any flaps on board and it's not going to have any heat shielding for Earth re-entry, but it will be reusable from lunar orbit to the moon surface and back again. And of course, there are many people that are skeptical about the Starship just because of the sheer scale of it and the fact that everything is public and we can see things like the prototypes explode in a very public fashion. But even NASA Administrator Jim Bridenstine has given kudos to SpaceX for their ability to fail and fix. He said that SpaceX is very good at iterative testing and fixing as they're developing their vehicles. And really, it's just impossible to ignore the fact that if Starship is successful, it will provide a very low-cost option to NASA. And really, that low cost would be huge for NASA because that would help avoid the problems of the Apollo program, which was canceled because of the high cost. Now, there is a big difference in the dollar amounts that have been awarded to each company, but NASA is cautioning people not to read too far into that. It's not showing preferences or favorites in any way. Rather, those dollar amounts actually are reflective of what the company both requested and the scope of work that they're intending to complete over the next 10 months. Now, just like with the Commercial Crew program, NASA is intending to try to keep multiple contractors on board for developing these lunar landers. But ultimately, three contractors might be a little bit too much for their budget, so they may have to pare down that list. So, over the course of the next 10 months, NASA will be watching and participating in the development of these vehicles. But as this contract winds up, they may be forced to eliminate one of these providers. One thing that's still a little bit up in the air is NASA's Lunar Gateway. Originally, NASA had intended for the Lunar Gateway to be ready by the time Artemis 3 took astronauts to lunar orbit. But NASA has decided that they will not go through the gateway for Artemis 3, and instead they will meet up with one of these landers in lunar orbit without the gateway. At this point, though, NASA is still pushing hard for that lunar gateway. They do still feel that the lunar gateway is a key for a sustainable presence at the moon. The lunar gateway enables NASA to reach a whole host of orbits around the moon. So if they want to go to the North Pole, they can go there. If they want to go to the South Pole, they can go there. If they want to land somewhere around the equator, they can go there. The gateway can open up a lot of opportunities. Unfortunately, though, with NASA's big push for landing astronauts by 2024, some things just have to get deferred to farther down the road. One notable absence in all these contract announcements was that Boeing was left out of the mix. Now, Boeing did submit a proposal for a lunar lander, but NASA ultimately decided not to provide them funding for development. And it makes you wonder if this has anything to do with the recent failures from the Boeing Starliner. So, whose design do you like better, and which do you think will be ready by 2024? Any of them? All of them? Let me know what you guys think in the comments down below. Thanks again for watching. We'll see you in the next video. By Blue Origin, which also... SpaceX is very good at iteratively
at the moon.
Blue. Oh, what was that? Come on, get it together.